قالت يا ولدي لا تحزن، فالحب عليك هو المكتوب.
The revolution in Syria began March 2011. About 9 million fled their homes, so, and that's just in general, so you can imagine how many are in refugee camps, in the millions. And the thing is, all of our efforts have been focused on helping the physical health of refugees, and not even much thought has been given to what about their mental health. But even if we do succeed in helping them physically, how would the quality of their life even be if they're emotionally torn and going through so much pain and agony? That's a very important question for people to think about. So I was really happy when I heard about Beiti, because the children are, in my eyes, very important, because they are our hope. They are the next generation. They were brought into this world under this revolution that tore their whole lives apart and, you know, took many of their loved ones. They didn't get a chance to live life normally as their parents have, as the older generations have. They don't know what a normal life is. You know, this is a big problem in their upbringing and their future. How will they grow? How will they thrive? How would they know what is normal? Their normal is this chaos. They have to know that all these negative emotions are not the emotions that they should be feeling. The sadness, the cries and tears every day. So we have to bring the real normal to them and let them know that, no, this is temporary. You should play, you should feel happiness. We're gonna work towards bringing back positive things in life that they might not even imagine. So as they engage, as they watch, as they play and decorate it, they are introduced to the normal that should be. And the character in the story, Hanan, gets displaced from her tank, which she is attached to, and was forced into going from her home to a cup to a new home. And this is the story of millions of Syrian children. It'll bring some relief and just give them tips on how they can cope. They can write all over what they're feeling. They can personalize it. It'll become, you know, theirs. So Hanan, she takes it in a very positive way. You know, she notices what's around her. She relates what was in her old tank to her new tank, makes new friends. You know, she looks at it in a very positive way. And this is something that's really important for them to learn, you know, how to take this all in. Yes, things are gone. Yes, you're meeting new people, but it's all gonna be okay in the end, and take some tips from the story.
So this is where the movie would play. And then the speakers inside, so you'd be able to hear the movie. And then when there wasn't enough battery to play the movie anymore, you'd just put it in the sun.
Wait, it's solar power.
Yeah. Yeah?
They hang in some houses.
Yeah. So just like those houses, this one is solar powered too.
Yeah.
So when you run out of battery,
you can build a solar. You can
they can solar use the sun's power.
Exactly.
No, I like it more than you.
No, I like more than you.
Who's that?
Hanan.
That's Hanan.